On a Sunday morning in the village of Kimitong, South Sudan, a 6-year-old boy named Lopez Lamong was kidnapped during church. He was stripped from his family and taken to become a trained soldier for Sudan's civil war. He was taken to a prison camp where he saw boys die from starvation and abuse every day. After some time, he and three other boys, who he called his three angels, escaped from the camp and ran for 3 days, eventually reaching a refugee camp in Kenya. Here he spent the next 10 years of his life, living with other boys, playing soccer, running around the camp, and working for a local farmer. Since there were so many boys that wanted to play soccer, a rule was made that before you could play, you had to run around the 18-mile border of the camp. This is the first time Lamong says he found enjoyment in running. One night after working for the farmer, he went with a group of boys to watch Michael Johnson win the 400-meter dash gold medal on a black and white TV in the farmer's house. After seeing this man cry on the podium stand, with thousands of fans cheering, Lamong was inspired to do the same thing. One day, when he was 16 years old, the UN and US government program came to the refugee camp announcing that they will be taking some boys to live in America. Whoever wrote the best stories about themselves will get a ticket on the plane. Lamong did exactly that and was one of the 4,000 boys selected to get families in America. Lamong was adopted by a family in Tully, which is in upstate New York. Here, he felt so thankful and determined to take advantage of this opportunity. He learned English, ran and studied in high school, and discovered how to live the American way. Showing incredible running potential, Lamong moved on to Northern Arizona University, where he won 2 NCAA championships. In July 2007, Lopez Lamong became a citizen of the United States of America, and in 2008, he became a professional runner. That same year, he made the Olympic team. He proudly represented the United States of America in the Beijing Olympics. Not only did he make the semifinals of the 1500-meter race, but was voted to be the flag bearer in the opening ceremony, which was a huge honor. "I'm here to compete for my country," Lamong told reporters when they asked him questions about human rights. "The Olympics are supposed to bring people together to peacefully blend, and I'm looking forward to do that, and stepping on the track and wearing my colors and representing my country." In 2008, Lamong returned to Sudan with an organization in his name. He partnered up with World Vision to help people in Sudan get clean water, education, nutrition, and medicine. He wants to do something big and special for the country he was born in. "I want to be the one telling that story to the people who never had a voice before, because there's a lot of kids out there right now, and they are still going through the things I went through. They are still getting kidnapped, they are still going hungry for days, they still do not have families," he says. Lamong also wrote a book called Running for My Life, One Lost Boy's Journey from the Killing Fields of Sudan to the Olympic Games. It describes his inspiring story and shows the world why he is running. Lamong is quoted saying, "We need to be able to tell the world to stop those things and let's educate kids instead of giving them AK-47s to go to fight. Let the kids go and play and do anything they need to do to be able to see their future."